Over the past 2 years, Special Counsel Robert Mueller's team, along with America's top intelligence agencies, have demonstrated one clear fact. The Russian government meddled in the 2016 presidential election. This is the first glimpse we got into Russia's interference in the election. It's the summer of 2016, and hacked and stolen emails from the Hillary Clinton campaign and the Democratic National Committee are publicly released, some via the website WikiLeaks. Cybersecurity experts quickly suggest Russians were behind the hack, but no evidence is provided. Candidate Donald Trump routinely downplayed suggestions that Russia was interfering.
It could be Russia, but it could also be China. It could also be lots of other people. It also could be somebody sitting on their bed that weighs 400 pounds, okay?
As the presidential campaign continues in the fall of 2016, American intelligence officials brief members of Congress that the Russian government is looking to interfere in the election. In September, at the G20 meeting in China, President Obama reportedly warns Russian President Vladimir Putin to stop his nation's interference. 2 months later, Donald Trump wins the presidency. But before his inauguration, the Obama administration publicly points the finger at Russia for the Clinton email hack, and in retaliation, levies sanctions on Russia and expels 35 Russian nationals from the U.S. The next month, a declassified intelligence report, written with input from the FBI, the CIA, and the NSA, states that Vladimir Putin personally ordered a cyber and social media campaign to disrupt the recent U.S. presidential election. And it states that Putin had a clear preference for Donald Trump. According to the report, Putin, quote, aspired to help President-elect Trump's election chances, when possible, by discrediting Secretary Clinton and publicly contrasting her unfavorably to him. In February of 2018, Robert Mueller's first indictment against the Russians drops.
The indictment charges 13 Russian nationals and 3 Russian companies for committing federal crimes while seeking to interfere in the United States political system.
Mueller's team lays out a sweeping case, directly accusing Russian citizens and companies of a massive, coordinated disinformation campaign to sabotage the election.
The defendants allegedly conducted what they called information warfare against the United States, with the stated goal of spreading distrust towards the candidates and the political system in general.
The indictment accuses the Russians, who worked out of this building in Moscow, of stealing American identities, setting up fake accounts on Facebook and other social media sites, and spreading false and inflammatory information. According to the indictment, their work isn't limited to the internet. Russians allegedly traveled across the U.S., hid their identities, and staged political rallies. The indictment also confirms the Russians had a favored candidate. Quote, by early to mid-2016, defendants' operations included supporting the presidential campaign of then-candidate Donald J. Trump and disparaging Hillary Clinton. 5 months later, another Mueller indictment. 12 more Russians are indicted by Mueller's team, including members of the GRU, a unit of Russian military intelligence. That's their headquarters. They're accused of hacking and stealing the Democratic National Committee and Clinton campaign emails.
The goal of the conspirators was to have an impact in the election.
No collusion.
None of the Mueller indictments thus far have indicated that any member of the Trump campaign was involved or aware of this meddling in the election.